Two of the most popular numerical analysis applications, Excel and R, can calculate confidence intervals around a single mean if you supply the raw data. I show you how to arrange that in this video, and we'll start with Excel. Please note that I'm using a PC, and some steps may be different on a Mac. Also, please note that recent versions of Excel differ in whether the ribbon labels a group as analysis or as analyze. Suppose that you have a sample of numbers as shown in column A of this worksheet. You'd like to calculate their mean and put a 95% confidence interval around that mean. Here's one reasonable way to do that in Excel. Click the Ribbon's Data tab and locate the Analysis group. Unless someone has customized Excel's ribbon, the Analysis group is usually at the right end of the Data tab. If you don't see the Analysis group, you should begin by installing either Excel Solver or the Data Analysis add-in, or both. The Data Analysis add-in is sometimes called the Analysis Tool Pack, or ATP. Click the Data Analysis item in the Analysis group. The Data Analysis dialog box appears. Locate Descriptive Statistics in the Analysis Tools list box and click OK. Click in the Input Range edit box and then drag through the range that contains your data. That's A1-17. If you don't want to use a label such as cost or miles per gallon, you don't have to, and in that case, you would identify the range A2 to A17 as the input range. Normally, you have your data in Excel's list format. That is, different values are in different rows, and all the values for a particular variable occupy the same column. If that's how your data is laid out, fill the Grouped by Columns option button. This is fairly typical. If the first row of that range contains a label, fill the label's checkbox. I have supplied the label score in cell A1 for this data set, and so the label's checkbox should be filled. Click the Output Range option button, and then click in its associated edit box. Click in the cell on the worksheet where you want the output to start. That cell should have at least one empty column to its right and at least 15 empty rows below it. Assuming that all you want is the confidence interval, fill both the Summary Statistics checkbox and the Confidence Level for Mean checkbox. Also, enter the confidence level that you want Excel to use. For example, if you want a 90% confidence interval, enter the number 90 on the edit box. Don't enter a decimal. Click OK. You'll get a table that shows the level of confidence that you chose, and below that, you'll see a single number. Despite the label, confidence level, that Excel uses, that number is the confidence interval's half width. You can subtract and add that amount to the mean. The result will be the confidence interval's lower and upper bounds. Excel gives you another way to calculate the confidence interval that you might find a little quicker than using the data analysis add-in. It involves using a worksheet function, confidence.t. Let's check out how it compares to the add-in method that we just looked at. To use the confidence.t function, you need to supply it with three pieces of information. The first piece is the confidence level. It's unfortunate, but the confidence.t function needs to know the alpha level that you want to use. That alpha level is always 1 minus the confidence level. So if you wanted the 95% confidence interval, you specify alpha as 1 minus 95%, or 5%, or 0.05. Then you need to tell Excel what the standard error is. That's easy enough by just using the Excel worksheet function for the sample standard deviation, or if you're working with sample means, the standard error of the mean. I'm not going to try to pronounce its name, but you can see it here in the formula bar. Notice that the tag is .s for sample rather than .p for population. Third, you need to tell Excel how many cases there are in the sample. You can just type the number into the formula, so here you would type the number 16, or you can use the count function instead, as I have here. The confidence.t function returns the distance between the mean of the sample and either the upper or lower bound of the confidence interval. Notice that confidence.t returns a value identical to the value that is returned by the data analysis add-in in cell D16. So those are two ways to calculate confidence intervals in Excel. For various reasons, including the fact that R is freeware, you may prefer to calculate your confidence intervals using R rather than a different, pricier package. In that case, you may need to import the data into R from something such as a CSV file, or even directly from an Excel workbook. Let's start by setting a CRAN mirror. From the Packages menu, select Set CRAN Mirror. I'll set it to USA CA1. Then I need to install a package that will be used called DeskTools. So navigate to Install Package from the Packages menu. Once that's done, you're ready to use the functions we need. Let's establish the DeskTools package by typing library, open paren, DeskTools, close paren. It's also important that you have Excel running. The worksheet that contains your data should be active, and the dataset itself should be selected. Then, we can import the data from Excel, naming it sample data by typing sample data less than dash Excel get range open paren header equals false close paren. It's possible that R will not comply with your request when you run Excel get range. If R tells you that RDCOM client is not available, use this R command. install.packages, open paren, single quote, RDCOM client, single quote, comma, repos, equal sign, single quote, HTTP, colon, /, www.omegahat.net/r/ close parenthesis. When the package RDCOM client has been downloaded and unpacked, continue with Excel get range as I just described. Since we're not going to import the label, I'll make sure the header is false. The next step is to convert the imported data to a numeric vector so that we can get the confidence interval. I can do that by typing sample data less than dash as dot numeric open paren unlist open paren sample data close paren. Now I can get the confidence interval by typing mean CI open paren sample data close paren. When you compare those values to those you find in Excel using the Data Analysis Tool Pack, you'll see that the results are identical.